Hello, hello, hello. Welcome to my channel, my dear friends. My name is Abhilash and I'm a trader next door. In this video, I'll be analyzing the chart of GBP/JPY, British Pound, Japanese Yen. So if you're watching my videos for the first time, then please subscribe to my channel for regular market analysis and do check out the Forex analysis playlist on my YouTube channel for the analysis of other pairs like Euro, USD, GBP, USD, Gold, USD and many more. So let's get started. So this is the 4-hour chart of GBP/JPY in front of us right now, and if you have watched my previous videos, then you can easily recognize these levels because I have been discussing these levels for quite some time. And if we look at the overall chart of GBP/JPY, then we can see that this is a sideways market. The market is sideways. It means that the number of buyers and number of sellers are almost equal, because in a trending market, if a market is in uptrend, then the market is under the dominance of buyers, and if a market is in downtrend, then the market is under the dominance of sellers. But in a sideways market, the number of buyers and sellers are almost equal, so as a result, we get trading opportunities on both the sides. Or in simple words, area of value. Okay, area of value or the best trading opportunities in sideways market are available at the resistance as well as at the support, because in an uptrend market, the best trading opportunity or the best buying opportunity is always near the support, whereas in a downtrend market, the best selling opportunity is always near the resistance. But in sideways market, we get the opportunity on both the side. Oh, I have talked a lot. So right now you can see that market is trading at 151.32. this is the current market price here, and if we buy here looking at the bullishness in the market, then obviously our stop loss will be here below 149.50 level. So you can easily see that we are taking a huge risk here if we are buying here, and at the top we have a resistance, so our risk to reward ratio does not match. And on the other hand, if we short the market here, then actually there is no logic of shorting the market here, because right now market is bullish. Therefore, this is our no trading zone, or right now the market is in the no trading zone, because our risk to reward ratio does not match. And for proper place here, we will either have to buy here or we need to short the market here. Right now market is here, so we will not do anything. We will wait for the perfect time. We will wait for the right time to either go and hit this level or hit this level. As right now market is trading near this 151.75 level, and you can see that this is a resistance for the market, or in simple word, this is a whole resistance zone. This is a whole resistance zone for GBP/JPY. You can clearly see on the chart. So therefore, there is a possibility of market reversing from 151.75 or 80 level. Just keep in mind, in case market crosses also this level, okay, in case market crosses also it's 152 level, extremely sorry, okay. So in case market crosses also the level of 152, then also we will not go for shorting the market. Why? Because see, this is a whole resistance zone. Until and unless market reverses and we get the confirmation that yes, market is reversing at last, we will not short the market. Okay, only short the market if you see a red candle, if you see a shooting star candlestick pattern, then only short the market at the resistance. Because keep in mind, support and resistance level in the market are not permanent. There is a possibility of a breakout as well, and this is the main reason we need to wait for the confirmation, because we know that 90% traders lose money because they do not follow few basic rules. My dear friends, if you do not want to make the same mistake, then wait for the market to reverse. And once you get the confirmation that yes, market is reversing from the resistance zone, then you can short the market. And on the other hand, if market comes down, suddenly market comes down to the level of 149 level, then you can obviously go for buy if market bounces. Yes, confirmation is always essential, and you'll get the confirmation in the form of a hammer pattern or a big green candle like this. Once you see market bouncing from the 149.50 level, then only go for buy. And when market will reverse from here, then only go for sell. No trade without confirmation. Okay, that's it. This is a strategy that you can follow for GEP JPY for today. Bye bye, take care, see you tomorrow.